God who is ahead of my life.
Amen.
And to the Lord, the Lord, who is all this given and praying. I'm up here this morning, I'm giving a testimony, and it's not really a testimony, it's more of an inspirational message. And we family, right, church?
Yeah.
I was supposed to do this since last month, but the devil has been on my time. I was scared, thinking people were gonna judge me, talk about me.
It works on any family.
And I'm here now today.
Amen.
Many of you know me from growing up in the church. Y'all know my story with my mother and my father. It's been hard growing up without my parents, but I thank God that He placed me with my family.
Yes.
I don't know where in life I would be without them. Growing up, I used to get teased about my mother. It was hard. But God did it all. I'm 25 years old, and it still affects me today about the situation of my mother. But I thank God, because if my mother would have raised me, God knows where I would have been. But now, I didn't have my biological mother, but I had my God-fearing grandmother who raised me right. Whatever you do, do not give up on God. Because you may not come where you want to go. I'm working minimum wage making over $100 a week, but I am genuinely happy. I had a cousin tell me, she was like, what's wrong with you? Your nails not done, your hair not done, your feet not done, like, what's going on? I'm like, I'm working a minimum wage job, but I'm happy. Like, I'm genuinely happy. And it's been a long time since I could feel like this, and I thank God for making me feel like this. The Lord has been blessing me, and I'm just trusting in Him, and I can just imagine what He's going to do for the rest of my life. And I just want to tell you, please, whatever you do, do not give up on God.
Okay. I promise you that.
Thank you. President.